Netcasts you love.
From people you trust.
This is Twit.
Radford Castro's here. We seem to give him all the laptops.
Yes.
I think we gotta be careful not to typecast you, Radford. But you
laptop
just
man.
You seem to be the guy who likes the laptops. You like light laptops.
Yes.
This is a Toshiba's Portage is a time-honored mark in the laptop. Light laptop area. They've been making really, really light laptops for longer than anybody else.
Yes.
Now we have this Ultrabook category. Is this Toshiba's Ultrabook?
Yes. This is one of Toshiba's many Ultrabooks.
They have a huge,
basically, portfolio of Toshiba lineups, and this sits right in the middle of it. But just to give you a quick gist on it, too, this is not touch, and this is not full HD. This is 1366 by 768, 13.3 inches display. So
kind of low-level specs for a laptop price point.
Exactly. So that by itself already is kind of hard to...
I see a fingerprint reader. It sounds like it's aimed at a business market.
And I wanted to get into that point. But before we do, I guess I wanted to show a little bit about the
please
specs.
Please do.
Yeah, so we have 8 gigabytes and 128 gigabytes of SSD hard drive space.
Okay.
And then, again, of course, you got your other things like your cameras and stuff like that. I've sent... some screenshots of the ports that are available on there. And so you'll see some stuff, some things that hark back to the back days that are like the RGB out and HDMI out. You got a couple of ports, most of them being USB 3.0. But it's a pretty light laptop. I mean, it looks good when you close it. When you open it, it feels a little outdated, mostly because of the fact that you're seeing a touchpad that's a little bit off. You have two sets of buttons here, so you have a right click and left click on the bottom and at the top for whatever reason. And you also have this...
Well, that is from what I've read, whenever you use the pointing stick, you use these for your...
Oh, so you want the button near the pointing stick. That makes sense, instead of down at the bottom of the...
Yeah, I'm used to pressing it this way, though. I'm not used to the... This is something back in the ThinkPad days that I'm used to seeing.
Right.
But for the most part, it's decent. I mean, performance-wise, when you're playing with the laptop, you can do all the normal things you would expect it to do. But the thing that really sticks out the most, again, is the fingerprint. The fingerprint is something that's, I guess, decent. It works okay. It's just another security
thing. Is that it on the left there?
Yeah, this is actually it right here.
Oh,
it's
actually on the trackpad?
Right on the track. Well, it's not necessarily on the trackpad.
It's just out right of the below. Shot a little bit. Can you move it there?
Right
now
there.
I see it. Yeah.
Right here.
Yeah.
But yeah. I have some screenshots of it, because you can't really see with this kind of screen because of the refresh rate.
I guess the real question, how accurate is it?
It's pretty accurate.
So reliable.
It's very reliable.
You would trust it to have it be the only way your machine is locked.
Right.
Okay.
And this is how the interface looks like. So you select which finger you want, and it goes through the whole step of you going through the fingerprint process over and over again.
Yeah.
The laptop is decent. It's 2.6 pounds. Outside, like, the keyboard feels pretty good. It's supposedly spill-resistant. I haven't actually tried to do it, obviously, because it's a review unit. I haven't dunked it or anything, but it's okay. But for this kind of price, it's not...
It's an i5, right?
It's an i5.
All right. Windows 7?
It's Windows 7, but it also has 8.1 license, so you can install either
one. Okay, so you get your choice. That's
nice. So you get your choice, yeah.
And you said it's Haswell. It's fourth generation core.
Okay. Yeah. And also, it comes with 1 year of Office Online.
Haswell gives you pretty good battery life.
Yeah.
Right?
This actually, I tested, it's about 10 to 12 hours, so that's really good.
I like that.
Yeah.
I'll tell you, my disappointment is the screen.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. And the weird layout of the trackpad.
Yes. Also disappointed the fact that it doesn't have like the drive. I guess I'm expecting more anemones for something at this price.
$1,250, you should have more.
Yeah, you're looking at almost gaming laptop type of price.
Right.
For something like this, which is your typical casual laptop.
Pros and cons.
Pros and cons. Pros is that it's nostalgic. It feels nostalgic.
I remember the Portage.
Yeah, I remember those days. It has a few things. Well, the fingerprint, obviously, that's another thing that's cool. The cons is that it's just outpriced. It's outdated. It's behind in the times in terms of what it needs to be in terms of like portability and...
Right.
And
I like it on this page, on the Toshiba page, on the screen, it says, as a selling point, no integrated webcam or microphone.
But it does. This is actually the 1300.
You can order it updated.
Yeah.
All right.
But
there are people who that's a selling point. I don't want a camera because I'm just going to tape it over. I don't want it.
Right. It's just crazy because when you go to Toshiba's website, they just have tons and tons and tons of...
You can skew it like crazy.
Yeah, they're just tons of skews.
All right.
But unfortunately, at the very end, I have to give this a don't buy.
I think just price alone, maybe 800 bucks, this would be a buy, you think?
Yeah. And it starts at 800 bucks, but even then, its lowest end is not up to par in terms of like what it's going out.
I haven't seen a VGA port in a laptop in a long time.
It's an RGB
That is
VGA
hysterical.
Port. It's crazy.
Radford Castro, our director of engineering. Unfortunately, sorry, Toshiba.
Sorry.
Do not buy.
But send us some more.
On the Portage Z30. Hey, I'm sure they have other
more
great
coming.
Stuff.